Matthew chapter 7, our text comes from the 24th verse through the 27th verse. The Bible reads, "Therefore, whoever hears these sayings of mine and does them, I will liken him to a wise man who builds his house on a rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, and it did not fall, for it was founded on the rock. But everyone who hears these sayings of mine, Jesus Christ, and does not do them, I will liken him to a foolish man who built his house on the sand. And the rains descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, and it fell. And great was its fall." Can you say amen? These verses come from our Lord and our Savior, Jesus. And this 24th verse of Matthew chapter 7, Jesus is speaking with the disciples, and it is interesting because he pulls a contrast in his parable. And it's black and it's white. It's positive and it's negative. Many times in life we believe that everything is great. And the world would want you to believe that because the world likes great. The world loves great. The world loves ambiguity. The world loves compromise, mediocrity in its walk, in its stance. But Jesus is saying that there are two different scenarios in which you will live your life. One in which the foundation that you have is secure and one that is not secure. One that is safe and one that is dangerous. He gives us choice. He gives us, let me say it in a different way, opportunity. Hallelujah. That one's obedience to Christ's word makes all the difference. Or the lack thereof. Christ has given us the power. He has given us the power to place a house, a built structure. Our life, us. The things that we do on solid foundation. Or not. And he guarantees two results. I want to talk to us today just for a short period of time from the subject, the right foundation. Look at your neighbor and say, you got to have the right foundation. You got to have the right foundation. There was a person that got caught speeding. They call it, got a speeding ticket, and they had to go to defensive driving. Can I get an amen? Sitting in defensive driving, listening to the instructor, he gives a scenario. He says, if you're sitting in a car and somebody's speeding up behind you, and you see them in the rearview mirror, and you know they're about to hit you, what do? Do you let your foot off the brake? And most of the class said, yeah, man, because you know when it hits, you know, it lessens the impact, you know, because it pushes the car forward. And the guy said, no, that is wrong. He said, if you look back and you see a car coming about to rear end you, and you're sitting at the light, he said, you stomp on your brakes and you prepare for the impact. He said, because when it hits you, your car will be sitting on a firmer foundation. It'll be less damage to your car and less damage to those that are inside. He said, if you let your foot off of the brake and prepare for impact and it hits you, you get the whiplash effect. And isn't that like life? that many times we go through issues and troubles and situations and our foundation is not right. And because our foundation is not right, then we find ourselves with the whiplash effect. Life has shocked us. Life has caught us unaware. Life has jumped us and we don't know how to handle it and everything's falling apart. You have that whiplash effect. I didn't see it coming. I didn't think they'd leave this soon. I didn't think it happened like this. I gave all my life to this job and then I put everything into this child and him and her and I didn't know. The word of God says that it's appointed to man once to die. Somebody needs to say amen right now. That you're not going to live forever and if you're in Christ and if you're secure, you know where that person is going. The word of God says that we celebrate. Why? Because they have run the race. They have finished. I know in our selfishness that we're going to miss them, but they finished their race. And they've gotten their reward if they're in Christ. We understand that God can restore. We understand that God said that all things are going to work out for your good if you stick with them. And whatever comes upon us that we are in Christ, that he is able to give us the strength when we have done all we know to do, stand there for. When you're on the right foundation, you can survive. And Christ wants you to survive. No, Christ wants you to thrive. But you have to do it on the right foundation. He says that this should be good news to you, that if you're rooted and grounded in Christ, if you have the right foundation, that guess what? It's going to work out. Yes, the rains will come. Yes, the storm will blow. Yes, the flood will come. See, that rain is on issues. And you know how rain just gets over everything. Issues get over everything. Issues are everywhere. Can you say amen? You find that flood comes, these floods that come upon you, that's when you get in over your head. Anybody been over their head before? And it seems like you're drowning in debt, or you're drowning in an emotional hurt, you're drowning in this area and that area, and it seems like you'll never survive. But God says, stay on this foundation. He says, stand on the rock. And when you stand on a rock and you stay rooted and grounded in me, you'll survive. Look at the neighbor and say, you'll survive, you'll survive. Yeah, the violent storms come in our life and they blow in and they blow out. You may be in a storm right now. You may be going through something right now, but guess what? Trouble don't last. Boy, somebody need to praise the Lord right there. I thank God that trouble don't last always. And I know that. Guess what? It may not be that God takes it away, but he takes you what? Through. And see, when you're in Christ and you understand him, you understand that he wants to give you the wings to make it through, to fly through the storm. Can somebody say amen? He's not going to sink your boat. He's not trying to destroy you with a storm. He's trying to perfect you. He's trying to bring out of you something greater than you even see in yourself. Come on, can you praise him right now? The quality of your foundation is reflected when the storm comes in your life. When that storm hits you, what's the quality like? Man, you don't have to say amen. You don't have to say anything. You don't have to look left to the right, but think of it. When storms come in your life, that shows you what you're made of. That shows you whose you are and whose you're not. 1 Corinthians chapter 3. It's worth noting. You can write this down. Verse 10 through 15. The Bible says, now if anyone builds on this foundation, we're talking about that right foundation. and foundation on the rock. If anybody builds on this foundation, verse 12, it says, with gold or silver or precious stones, hay, stubble. It says, each one's work will become clear. For the day will declare, because it will be revealed by fire. Wow. And the fire will test each one's work of what sort it is. What's your work? What you're building on? That we have to understand it, that when we are building our life, when we are building up the things in life, are they built on the right foundation? A, and then number two, what kind of materials are you using? See, you have to understand it's broken down into two categories: gold, silver, precious stones. These things don't rot away. These things don't break down. But hay and stubble and wood, they disintegrate. So you have things that you can build on your foundation that are good. And you have things that you can build that are negative. What are you building in your life right now? Will it survive the fire? See, you have to understand that fire represents purification. Represents holiness. The things that you are building in your life, are they of godliness or not? Are they holy? Are they praiseworthy? Man, it's so quiet in here. You can hear a mouse dancing on cotton. What is your foundation right now? We think we have a great foundation, and then your foundation may be okay, but your building materials may be lackluster. Your building materials may be of a corruptible kind, of a disintegrating kind, of a rotting kind. It looks good at first, but it breaks down. That's one thing about cheap material. Can somebody say amen? It looks good for right then, but then it breaks down. Anything that's subpar, it breaks down easily. But you got a deal. But you got your groove on. But you got your hustle on. But boy, it looked like you came up quick, but you fell just as quick. Look at your neighbor. Don't say nothing to him. Amen. Watch this. Verse 14 says, if anyone's work which has been built, if it endures, he will receive a reward. If anyone works or burned, he will suffer loss, but he himself will be saved, yet as though through the fire. The quality of your foundation is in level with obedience to the word. The quality of your foundation is reflective in your obedience to the word of God. Oh boy. Just throw your hands up and ride the roller coaster. It's okay. we have to understand that some people are saved, but they're empty. Some people have Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, but they don't have anything built upon that rock. Okay, I'm gonna come to the side. Some people have lived their life in Christ, but at the end, they have nothing to show for it. You have lived an empty life, and you have praised God and what happened, but you didn't do nothing with it. You got the golden ticket. Why didn't you use it? You had access. You had everything at your disposal, but because of fear or because of the lack of getting in the Word of God, you were not able to build anything worth anything. Only the things that are done will last. What are you building? We're sitting in here and our kids are around us and our loved ones are around us and we're just here waiting for God to do something. But when we leave this place, we got to put our hard hat on. When we leave this place, we ought to put some more tools on our belt. When we leave this place, we got to get busy. We got work, because when we work and it's day, guess what? We can build all kind of things for God. But when night comes, can't nobody work. Can you say amen? Can you give them some praise right now? Look at the name and say, I'm ready to work. I'm ready to go to work. I'm ready to go to work. I want to build something for Christ. I want to do something for him. I want something that's going to last longer than today. Well, my kids will be able to look back and say, man, my daddy loved God. He taught me the word of God. He prayed with me. And they're not caught unaware. And it can build. But as the word says, tell them, be careful how you build. On the foundation that's already been laid. Can't no other foundation been laid that has been laid. See, there are two ways that your house will be destroyed. Amen. Number one is using inferior building materials. We already talked about that if you're building your life on a bad understanding of God's word. I didn't get no amens right there, huh? Amen. If you have a bad understanding and you're building your life on materialism, or you're building your life on your pride and your arrogance, and you the man, you the, if you're building your life on these temporary things, they will not last. It will not last. You are building a faulty building structure. Yes, you know Jesus. But what ends up happening is we end up looking like hypocrites. We end up looking foolish in front of others. That we are supposed to have a testimony, but you got a shack instead of a mansion. No. Your structure leaning like this, and people halfway want to stay in it. Y'all, see, y'all ain't never lived in a shack before. That's why everybody like, what? See, if you ever been in one of them shady houses, I used to work for an AC place. We used to have to go in and look at any kind of, every kind of house. You walk in and you just kind of, you know, man, the breeze is about 10 miles. I'm not going in there. I don't know if it's going to blow down. I don't know if it's creaking. And that's how our houses are that we're building. And so you wonder why nobody ever wants to come and hang. The only people that want to hang with you are people who hang in places like, see, I done got off you know, roaches and all that. Yeah, like that. And all them kind of people love hanging with you. How many people got roaches hanging around them? Don't raise your hand. Amen. But see, roaches love them kind of places. They rats and they thrive in those kind of places. Amen. But when you go to a nice structure, a nice house, you shouldn't see roaches. You shouldn't see roaches running everywhere. You shouldn't see rats all in the house. I'm talking about people. I'm talking about people, amen. Who you hanging around? Who you hanging around? Who's in your life? You got roaches in your life, amen. You got rats in your life. You shouldn't have them in your life, amen. If you're built on the right foundation, they shouldn't feel comfortable in your nice built house. Come on, somebody praise the Lord right now. And number two, I'm almost done. Number two, that if you tamper with the foundation, two ways you can destroy your inferior building materials. And then number two, if you tamper with the foundation, what am I talking about? If you try to change your relationship with Christ. If you say that the word doesn't say that. If you say that he's okay with doing this, this, and that, you know that's not what he said. But you want to go with the thought that, yes, I can do these things and get away with it. I can act like this in public. Participate in this, that. I know what the word says, but you know what? We move past that. We in modern times. This is post-racial, post-this, post-that. Everybody want to put past everything, but you still are in the same situation. Ain't nothing new under the sun. means gray and trying to hustle and trying to skirt the rules and regulations that God has put down the principles. We start trying to change the foundation. And so when the storm comes, your structure's down, but the waters start rising. Yeah, they start rising, and your house still standing, but you got mold in it. And it's making you sick. Your house is still standing, but you got water raining in from the ceiling. Your house is still standing, but the breeze is blowing through. And you think that you're safe. And it looks good from the outside. See, y'all ain't seen no houses like that. It looked good from the outside. But when you walk in, it's a mess. See, Christ said, clean the inside. He said, outside look great. How does your outside look? Is your veneer beautiful? Are you put together? Do you know what to say, how to say it? But inside, if we put a microscope on your life, everything would come out. If we start looking very closely, you can't see the termites, right? See, that's the thing about termites. I don't know why I'm talking about this rats and roaches. I guess we're talking about building a house, right? But let me tell you something. I've known people who have had houses that look really good. And they were ready to sell. But as soon as they found out they had termites, somebody need to say amen. Yeah. All of a sudden the value shot down. But you couldn't see that from the outside. But when they inspected closer, can I tell you that God is always inspecting? That's what he talks about, is that fire is coming and he's going to visit you. In that day, he's going to show up in your life, and he is going to assess it. And it seems, I know somebody's going through that right now, probably. We all have ways in which we go through this, where it seems like God is putting a microscope on our life. Everything we've done, everything we've said, everything we've gotten into, just starts bubbling up Everything starts bubbling up. I can't even look at people. Everything starts bubbling up to the top, and you can't hide nothing in your life. And it seems like everything from strange places are coming. Why is he doing that? Because he is trying to get you to see you got some demonic termites. No. You got some people in your life who are termites. Okay, you building the wrong structure. Can I get a praise Lord on any of that? Hey, I got some amens over here. Structure in your life, and he's trying to expose it. The Holy Ghost comes in to inspect your life. And if you're being convicted about how you live, if you're being convicted about what you're doing, if you're being convicted about what you're into, he is your inspector. He is trying to help you live a holy life. Come on, praise the Lord. That he's a great inspector. God, inspect me. God, show me. God, I don't want to live a life of futility. I don't want to waste my time. Can I tell you, that's the one thing that you can't get back, time? You cannot get it back. See, the older I get, the more I realize I cannot waste time. That I need to be building towards something. I need to be leaving a legacy for something. I have to need to be doing something. And I need to make sure that my foundation is right. My building that I'm building for Christ is right. Because somebody's going to need it. My children are going to need it. Somebody else is going to need to peek their head in. And when they can't stand on their faith, somebody needs to say amen. When they are in the storm and their house is collapsing, you know how you run to the neighbor's house? Somebody's going to run to your house because they're going through, and they need to be able to run into a sound structure on the right foundation, and so they can get a new start, because we serve a God of a second chance. Come on, praise him. Hallelujah. See, that That foundation has to be based upon a good blueprint, Christ's blueprint. I'm gonna give you three things real quick, just to remember. Number one, that his life is a model for our living. His life is a model for our living. You don't have to guess. You don't have to say, how should I live this life? What should I do? His life is a model. So that means you need to learn his life. That means you need to know what he did, how he did it, what he talked about. Read the Gospels. Amen. Number two, we have to understand the commands of his word. What does his word ask us to do? You want to build a solid structure? Isn't it funny how the enemy hates us reading the word of God? It will put you to sleep. He will distract you. He will do everything he can to keep you away from reading the truth. The best defense against a lie is the truth. Hallelujah. So you know the word. You have to understand the commands of his word. You have to look at Christ modeling his life so we know how to live, how to treat people. Can you say amen? And then number three, we have to trust God to justify you and me. Okay, all right. We got to trust God, I'm coming closer to you, to justify you and me. If you understand that he has the last word, if you understand that he's the one you need to get approval from, if you understand he's the one that we do everything unto, I'm not worried about him or her. I'm not racing against this or that. I am serving Christ. I'm running his race. Hallelujah. He will justify it in. He will make sense of it. Because when I serve him, when I follow him, he's working everything out for my good. Hallelujah. He's working everything out. So yeah, it may not make sense to you, and it may not make sense to the other person why you built this over here and built that over there, because it looked good. That's why I put it up there, because Christ likes it. But people don't understand that because they want you to build your stuff a certain way. They're trying to pigeonhole you to be, look like this and to do and to be a rope. No, I'm not like that. I am made in the likeness in the image of my God. Come on, somebody need to get excited about that. That's a good place to praise him. And if he has made me in his likeness and his image and given me purpose and a mind and spoken to me and called me into his kingdom, that means he has something for me to do that's great. Look at your neighbor and say, he still has something for you. Hallelujah. Give him some praise right there. Hallelujah. He still has something for you. He is going to justify you, not people, not things. See, Oswald Chambers says that character is the evidence of what we are built on, the right foundation. Our character is evidence of the right foundation in which we're built. What's your character like? If your character is suspect, you're not built on the right foundation. If your character is good, you have a good foundation. Look at your neighbor and say, what you standing on? What you standing on? What are you standing on? See, I understand that we want to be a certain way in life. I understand that the need that we have to be significant, to prove to people, to show people, to say to people that my life and who I am matters. But God is the one that will justify you. But man, we have to really think, who are we trying to please? Because when you're trying to please the wrong people, you will step away from that right foundation. See, we have to understand that on the right foundation, it's not flesh. Many times the strongest structures are not flesh. But it is for a reason. What foundation are you standing on? Can I tell you that You may be on building on sands. That represents people, right? And that lasts for a little bit. That house cute for a little bit. But you ain't had no real storms in your life. And when those storms really come, see, I don't want you to get used to the rats and the roaches in your life. Right? It shouldn't be comfortable in your home. You shouldn't put up with that. Now, you see, when I was in college, we had rats and we had roaches and mice running through and stuff. We'd laugh and try to shoot them with a little BB gun. And no, nobody did like that. Okay. But the thing is, we were leaving our food. We wasn't washing. We were some guys. We wasn't washing dishes. We had all kinds of stuff laid out everywhere, you know, smelling, stinking. We just a bunch of dudes, man. We leave out. And then rats, these roaches and mice, and they just come easing on in. They felt comfortable. We thought it was funny. But see, when I grew up, got married, right? She had a better standard than, you know, y'all with me. She wasn't comfortable with them tree roaches. She wasn't comfortable with the little salamanders coming. Can I get an amen over here? She wasn't living like, she didn't grow up like, you know. She had a different foundation. And so I had to get with it. Can somebody say amen? And she and her family helped me to shift over, hallelujah, on the right foundation, amen. And once I got on the right foundation, the roaches started getting on my nerves. I ain't talking about the insect. I had to move on, amen. And so I had more peace at night, amen. Hey, because they wasn't just running around in my crib, y'all ain't with me. Yeah. Amen. I couldn't leave the house. You know, amen. But I just want to let you know that if you're in here today, that God does love you. That God does want you to be on the right foundation and in the right place. And He has afforded you that. Amen. Through His Word.